Hi guys, welcome to Femi's Desserts View YouTube channel. So today is another Monday motivation day. So you know I already promised before time that I'll be dropping something every Monday to motivate you. You know, more like the start of a new week to motivate people around who want to hear one or two things that might help them or boost their morale in their chosen fields of business, as the case may be, using bakers always as the main point of subject. So today I just want to talk about my first major fail in the baking business. That has actually been like the one and only big fail that I had through the course of the years that I've been baking, okay? And here it is. It was whilst I started my business. Okay, if I look back now, this is about my 8th year of business. So it all started whilst I was already in another state. I ran the business for almost 2 years, and then I migrated into the state that I am situated now. And then 1 year down the line, I already had a platform, like a good working platform on Instagram, okay, even Facebook as the case may be at that time. So I was strictly online, and I felt the need or the urgency to open a shop. Okay, so I put all my thoughts, I had projected how I pictured how the shop was gonna look, how I'll be having massive sales. You know how we all think, oh, okay, you have a shop, it's like the beginning and the end of everything. Once you have a shop, you have millions of walking clients and the likes of it. I'm sorry to disappoint you. That has stayed as the most epic and legendary fail I've ever had. One, the reason why I'm going to categorize this boldly as one of my epic fails is that I invested money, I invested resources, I even invested, you know, I just invested because I had projected. But one thing I didn't realize is that I wasn't working at the pace as which the business wanted to grow. You know, like I was just starting, and I was very desperate to get into the faces of people. I wanted to make an impact, I wanted to be relevant, and I had already seen other people opening up their shops. Now, me telling you that opening a shop is a major fail for me doesn't mean it's going to be a major fail for you. So don't get it wrong, I'm not trying to discourage anybody. I'm just trying to tell you that from my own point of view, you might even think something that you feel will push your brand forward is what you're going to do, and it wouldn't even leave your brand on the spot, it would actually regress your brand. So that's what it's called, it's a learning process. Those are the parts of the experiences that I can never forget. So going forward, I actually set up the shop. It was a space even right inside the filling station. You can imagine how I thought, oh, for everybody that drives in, you know, to buy fuel or anything, they would definitely stop by my shop. Ladies and gentlemen, I'm going to tell you for a fact that for 3 or 4 solid months post opening of the shop, I didn't have a single working client. Oh dear, it was very horrible, it was very discouraging, it was very destabilizing. I only just had my first baby at that time, so you can imagine now having to struggle to juggle from home, nursing the baby, and then going to the shop. At the end of the day, I now realized that the most, or let's say out of 100%, 98% of the clients I managed to get at that time were strictly on Instagram or online platform, and as well as referrals from those that have tasted my cake. I bought drinks, I make cupcakes, I make cake loaves, I make everything, and I even announced like an opening then, saying that for the first 100 people to walk in to make an inquiry, they're going to be getting free drinks and free cakes. Let me tell you something, you see those my 100 cupcakes, I can't even remember if they were exhausted really, because I think at the end of the day I even had to share it out, because the 100 I was even projecting to come, nobody came. Like, I couldn't cry, honestly, I couldn't cry. I'm just, you know, the purpose of this TED Talk. This purpose of this TED Talk is just to let people know that there are times in your baking business that you would make some certain decisions that would look like what would help project your brand, like I earlier stated, but they would actually end up almost discouraging you and yanking you out of the business in totally. So if not that I was dogged and I was determined to keep pushing, that was right enough reason for me to actually stop, because I was so destabilized and discouraged. Let me tell you, I think in those, I had the shop open and running for about 6 months. I paid the rent for 1 year. Ladies and gentlemen, I didn't even use up to 1 year. Alright, because I couldn't go. No, I couldn't. What I ended up doing at the end of the day was now, like, double spending. So instead of making profit, I was running at a huge loss. What I would do is, I didn't even now even project or map out my strategies properly. I didn't even have good lightning. I didn't even have anything. I now realized that what I used to do is I'd get orders on Instagram, online platform, right? And you know you can actually sort out your Instagram even if you don't have a shop. I'll take bookings on Instagram, then I'll execute in the shop. Realize that I don't even have good lightning enough to even get a good picture of my cake, and then I'll take the cake back home to snap pictures. And again, you know, it became so tasky because I'd realized that because of my baby, I'd not go on time. I'll go like 11 or about. By the time I bake, I'd need to chill the cake before I start working on it. Before you know it, it's 7 p.m. And yes, I had to leave to go back home. You know, then I was just trying to get my hands on everything and try to see whichever one would work for me. At the end of the day, the office space that I got ended up being just like a waste of money. I had just one single client inquiry in about 3 to 4 months. I'm not even joking. I won't tell you lies. I'm just giving you this maybe well-kept secret of mine that I have never shared to anybody, because I've gotten to the point where I don't see it as a shameful thing again. I'm no longer embarrassed, because then it was so embarrassing, like, I put it on my Instagram there. I took pictures of the sections of the for those that are actually very observant, I'm sure they would figure that the location changed. I ran back home to my comfort zone. Technically, like, my comfort zone, it even helped me project my brand better. Yeah, I was now working more late into the night. You have to give to take, like, you have to give something. It was like a sacrifice, okay? So I was working from home. I could even monitor what I was doing because I didn't have that, you know, that restriction in my head that, once it's 7 p.m. I need to go. So whatever it is, I'll be going home. I'll walk with my prom coat. I'll take the prom coat home because it was late and the area there wasn't so safe, and I couldn't stand the chance of maybe getting robbed or getting harassed in the neighborhood because I wanted to remain there. Because at that time, dating back to almost 6 years back, it was just a coming up area. I was almost like the only one running a business in that area. I ran, and I'm saying it now with full confidence that after that, I've actually made better, amazing business decisions. But that one was a no-no. It was a no-no, and the reason why I'm coming out to tell you now is just to motivate you guys. Even, you know, I even put out trainings and all of that at that time. Let me tell you something. I think I had only about one or two trainings. Yeah, one is actually thriving, and the other one even left the baking business to show you how baking is hard, but you just have to be dogged and you have to be strong-willed to keep at it. This is just a shorter talk to give you guys motivation, to let you know that your favorite baker girl too has had it rough, has made terrible, horrible decisions in the past, but it hasn't actually impaired me as to where I am now, okay? I must tell you, I'm proud of my growth. I look forward to growing even bigger, better. I look forward to more networking and improving myself in all of the areas, not only even in the baking, I mean in every aspect of the business, really, like in the management and everything, so that I mean it can always be better every single time. But this is it, I'm not even where I want to be yet. I am definitely not where I'm projecting to be now, but I'm not where I used to be then, and that was only because I was able to own up to the fact that I took that decision a bit too early. And because I took that decision a bit too early, I couldn't balance it out properly, and it was even going to regress my business. But instead of me regressing my business, I learned from it quickly. That is what it is about. When you make a mistake, I think that's about the summary of everything. When you make a mistake in your business, baking, or any business you find your hands to do, you'd need to realize on time and quickly get at how to correct your mistake or whatever it is you think you did to you know, drop the progress of your business in any way, so that you can learn from it fast. Or I say, when you fall, you get up. When you fall, you get up right back immediately. There's no time to sit down and mope and be sad and be like, oh, this shop, nobody has come on. In fact, I don't want to bake again. I look beyond everything. A lot of people will have said, like, oh, she closed her shop. Yes, I closed my shop because I had no sales for 4 months plus. You can imagine paying rent at the end of the year, and I had just one client that came to make an inquiry. How much can you do with that? I think it was about 10,000. I'm just giving you, like, I even desperately took that job then. Like, it's still so dear to me because it has, like, I looked at it with so much sentiment that, oh, at least someone has even come to place an order. And for those that even wanted to come at that time, they were coming to offer very ridiculous bargains for me, because at that point it was always eerie, silent, quiet, no activities for those that even used to come. They probably used to look like they're doing me a favor trying to patronize me in my shop. So please, guys, I went back to my online marketing. I'm still proudly an online baker. All right, so I have my platform for my physical trainings when the need arises. But I'm about 80% online and 20% physical. That's why when people ask me for my physical classes, there are a lot of dynamics and intricacies before I can actually take up a class. It's not because I don't want to take up a class. It's just because a part of me still remembers how I ventured into that and it was an epic feel. I'm not really sure I want to test those waters again. I'm still skeptical, but there are no barriers to learning, like I said. So if you need me to see physically, I'm very available. But I'm just trying to tell you, this is supposed to be on a lighter note. No hard feelings, nothing. I'm just trying to give you guys that push. If you fall down, get right back up and go for it. Keep going. Just keep going. If you make a mistake, you learn from the mistake and just do something that will not make you repeat that mistake again. So I think that's going to be all for now. Yeah, it was really short, right? I didn't want to bore you guys. I just wanted to give you this motivation to start up your week nicely, and so that, you know, you can have a blessed week. So till next time, guys, I remain your favorite girl, Famous Dessert View. As always, you know how we do it. Subscribe to the YouTube channel, all right? This very channel. Subscribe to it. Like the content you see. Go through the archives. Watch the videos and share with your friends and your loved ones. There are no barriers to learning. We are all here to learn one or two things so that we can all be better versions of ourselves in our craft and in anything. All right. So till next time, guys, Famous Dessert View. Bye-bye.